Welcome to the Spy Collection. My name is Anastasios and this is the second episode of the Digital Edition series, a series of videos for spy artifacts that only exist in digital format. For this video, I chose a top secret slide deck that was leaked by Eduard Snowden in May 2018. It was a presentation from Japan's Directorate of Signals Intelligence, known as DFS, at the headquarters of the NSA at Fort Meade in Maryland. Its historical value is that this document shows us step by step for the first time the use of SIGINT for cyber operations by Japan's DFS. Cyber operations, as we know today, have changed the world of modern espionage intelligence and counterintelligence. As you can see, not only the slides of the presentation were leaked, but also the speaker notes, making it easier for us to process and digest its content. This rare digital artifact comes from February 2013, when a DFS official presented it to the United States National Security Agency. Before I dive into the document itself, a quick overview of what SIGINT-enabled cyber means. A very rough description of this is that the Signals Intelligence Agency, that is SIGINT, is using their sources, such as interceptions, tapping on internet traffic, etc., to proactively detect cyber threats. For example, someone preparing a spear phishing campaign or an attempt to exploit some vulnerable systems of the defending nation. Once such a cyber threat is detected using SIGINT, the intelligence agency can decide how to react with the CNO. That is a computer network operation. For example, they might decide to deploy some protections against the threat, which makes it a CND, a computer network defense operation, or even hack back the adversary to obtain more intelligence on them, which will result in a CNE, a computer network exploitation operation. Or they might even decide to perform an operation to destroy the adversary's capability, such as taking down their systems, making it a CNA, a computer network attack operation. For Japan's DFS, the journey for SIGINT-enabled cyber operations started around 2011, and this is what this slide deck is about. The presentation also revealed for the first time MALLARD. This is a code name for a cover collection site in Japan. The program relies on satellite interceptions and is operated jointly by the NSA and the DFS. MALLARD is located at Tachiarai, and you can see a photo of it here. The domes that you see are just covers for the satellite dishes, both for protection from physical damage, but more importantly so that it's not visible where they are pointed, thus hiding which satellite broadcast they are capturing or the exact technology used for this. You can see, for example, here how such a dome looks like from the inside. This is not a photo related to the MALLARD station, but it gives you a perspective. As you can see, the quality of the PDF file contents varies, so I decided to reconstruct the entire slide deck and run through the presentation with you. I tried to make it as identical as possible, including any typos that were in the original one, but also moved it to a widescreen format. So, let's check it out. And here we are. DFS, SIGINT-enabled cyber, from February 2013. I was unable to find what specified top secret means in terms of legal requirements. I assumed that Japan and United States had very different classification systems, so this presentation was specified as top secrets for the United States regulations. If you know what this means, please let me know in the comments below. For the United States, top secret is used for information where unauthorized disclosure reasonably could expect to cause exceptionally grave damage to the national security. Also, another point for this slide is that you will see references to MOD, that's Ministry of Defense, and also JDIH, that is Japan Defense Intelligence Headquarters. I will now go through the speaker notes for this slide. It is my honor to visit the headquarters for the second time and give you a briefing. I would like to learn a lot about your SIGINT cyber operation and reflect it to DFS future project. Let me start my explanation about DFS SIGINT-enabled cyber operation. First, I'll talk about the history. In January 2012, Director General Defense Policy Bureau, and the redacted name, visited the United States and received explanation about the United States SIGINT-enabled cyber structure. After that, DSRJ offered the Ministry of Defense an explanation about SIGINT-enabled cyber, and the Ministry of Defense and DFS started working on cyber. Between March and May 2012, several study meetings with DSRJ were held. In early May 2012, DFS decided to promote the SIGINT-enabled Cyber project. At the end of May, the redacted name, director of Japan's Defense Intelligence Headquarters visited the NSA headquarters and had an intimate discussion with General Alexander, the director of the NSA, and both were aware of the necessity to cooperate in SIGINT-enabled cyber operations. And for the second slide, I will go through the speaker notes again. From June to November 2012, we worked on preparation to promote the project, as well as coordination for assistance from the United States side. At the APC SPC in June 2012, the NSA and DFS exchanged opinions regarding the promotion of SIGINT-enabled cyber project in DFS. DFS appreciates the United States' positive reactions to the action items. At the end of July 2012, DFS established a task force to proceed with the project. In early November 2012, relations with relevant organizations within the Ministry of Defense to promote the SIGINT-enabled cyber operation was established. Thanks to this relationship, DFS obtained specific material regarding attacks against the MOD network in mid-November 2012 and sent them to the United States in order to request advice for collection. In mid-November 2012, the redacted name, director of DFS, visited the United States and received explanation at the NSA about SIGINT-enabled cyber organization in the US, which was helped to consider the future of DFS organizational structure. And that was the second slide. Moving next, I will just go and do the same process as previously. So the speaker notes for this one are the following. In December 2012, DFS started its own SIGINT-enabled cyber operation using attack-related information provided by the J6. Especially since the end of December 2012, the DFS had a meeting with DSRJ almost every week and received explanation about how specific selectors would be loaded and was doing collection and analysis. However, we had no hits, probably because sustained targets at MALLARD, and then the rest of the text is redacted. Then it continues with, therefore, DFS asked the United States for information about SIGINT-enabled cyber-related carriers. We collected, on the name of the redacted carrier, a mail that matched with information from J6, which was a relay information of an email attack on the Ministry of Defense network. And that is this slide, moving next. And once again, going through the speaker notes, we read, we believe that DFS has reached to the starting point of SIGINT-enabled cyber operations thanks to the NSA's support and in-country effort by DSRJ. Cyber operation with selector update and SIGINT cyber collection has been started. With further cooperation with the NSA, we believe that great progress could be achieved in the future. And moving to the next slide. This is a very nice overview slide. It's like a retrospective roadmap. And we have the fiscal year, 2011, 2012, and 2013, and all of the milestones that were explained in previous slides. The only speaker notes for this one is that the slide depicts the aforementioned process that we have taken so far. And as we can see, it is more or less an overview of what was discussed, like the explanation of the explanation from DSRJ about the SIGINT-enabled cyber, then the study meetings that happened for SIGINT-enabled cyber. Then we also have a red star that I assume it means some sort of milestone. And this one is the decision to proceed with a project, to proceed with a SIGINT-enabled cyber project. Another milestone in the early stages, it was the meeting between the director of the NSA and the director of Japan's Defense Intelligence Headquarters, and they both recognized the necessity for cooperation. Then we had a small gap in May-June, and in mid-July it started the preparations to promote the projects and coordination for support from the United States. The other big milestone, the APC-SPC in 2012, where it was an opinion exchange that resulted in the establishment of the task force to proceed with this project in Japan. Then we have the inside Ministry of Defense in Japan relationships that were built during that time, also considered a milestone. And the information that DFS obtained from J6 and was sent to the US. Finally, we have that the DFS individually started doing SIGINT-enabled cyber operations. And also the DFS requested the United States for information to collect on cyber-related data. The collection against a specific carrier that the name has been redacted led the DFS to identify an email that was attacking the Ministry of Defense. And that resulted in selector updates and started a cycle operation for SIGINT-enabled cyber operation. That technically means that they were updating the threat selectors based on the intelligence they were gathering using this approach. And lastly, there is a field study on the NSA SIGINT-enabled cyber to help DFS develop even more. And moving to the next slide. Up to this point, we have a good idea of what happened until 2013 in terms of SIGINT-enabled cyber operations in DFS. From this slide on, we go into what is happening from 2013 and moving to the future, and keep in mind that this slide is from February 2013. Once again, I'm going to start by reading the speaker notes for this slide. Now, I will explain about our project in and after 2013. With regard to collection equipment, 5 small aperture antennas are scheduled to be operational at the end of March 2013. One of them is scheduled to be operated 24/7 for SIGINT-enabled cyber operation from April. As to Anonymous Internet, DFS already acquired budget and preparation to start operation is ongoing, aiming at IOC in October 2013. And moving next, going through the speaker notes again. Being authorized to organize SIGINT-enabled cyber structure, additional employees are scheduled to be assigned at the MALLARD office in Ichigaya and Tachiarai. In long-term perspective, by the end of March 2016, MALLARD system upgrade as well as WN system upgrade, i.e. introduction of MALLARD type system, are scheduled. At the same time as these upgrades, we are to make a budget request for reinforcement of SIGINT-enabled cyber capability. And this covers the future of the project, actually until 2016. And moving to the next slide, we have how the US could help Japan in this effort. Once again, I will go through the speaker notes for this one. Challenges and requests to the United States side. First, MALLARD current status and SIGINT-enabled cyber collection. MALLARD was originally introduced for traditional SIGINT collection, and is conducting about 200,000 sessions in a week. Data is saved for approximately 2 months. As DFS does research and analysis during that period, if preservation time is shortened, it will affect SIGINT operation at DFS. As I explained in history, DFS and redacted part about the carrier mentioned earlier, ISP carrier, redacted again, to collect SIGINT-enabled cyber data from this January. The number of collected sessions reached about 500,000 in 1 hour. Keeping this pace, MALLARD data storage period might be less than 1 week. As this affects our SIGINT operation, we are not able to do sustained collection for SIGINT-enabled cyber. Next slide, and speaker notes again. Thus, we are facing necessity of consideration, including how MALLARD could be operated. The DFS is considering about importing cyber-related case notations and other case notations into separate servers. We would like to see processing procedures which the US side employs in order to not affect traditional SIGINT collection, and would appreciate your technical assistance. Let me add that we had a meeting with DSRJ last Thursday, and they explained about the possible solutions further examination. We felt assured and are looking forward for the solutions. Next slide. Again, continuing through the speaker notes. Regarding collection target for SIGINT-enabled cyber. While the number of antennas DFS possesses is very limited compared to the United States, the DFS contribution to SIGINT-enabled cyber is highly expected by both inside and outside of DFS. As we need to pursue effectiveness in SIGINT-enabled cyber collection, DFS asked the United States for information on carriers which has cyber-related data. Next slide again. DFS SIGINT-enabled cyber operation flow is depicted here. J6 roles and function shown in the left include our assumptions, because J6 function is not disclosed to us. Their function include refining firewall settings, alerting users, malware analysis, cyber monitoring collection, storage and analysis of attack-related information. With the attack information provided by J6, we load selectors, collect and analyze SIGINT, reflect analysis result to the selectors, and in this cycle, we hope to discover indicators of cyber attack and provide J6 with threat information. This is an important slide, and I want to add two more things that were not explained in the speaker notes, and then we can move to the last part of the presentation. The first part is that you see CIRO being mentioned. That's the Cabinet Intelligence Research Office of Japan. And we can see that DFS is also receiving information from this channel. And the second part was that when the DFS provides attack-related information back to the J6, if that information is not related to the Ministry of Defense, that is getting escalated to the CIRO, who are taking care of this information and treat them accordingly. Now moving to the last slide of the presentation. This is the last slide, and I will be going again through the speaker notes. So here we are. Lastly, future SIGINT-enabled cyber operation. DFS SIGINT-enabled cyber operation is at an experimental stage. DFS will make every effort to do it alone and develop further, so it can provide information to Japanese customers as well as to the US side. For the future SIGINT-enabled cyber operation, we would appreciate the US cooperation. Thank you for your kind attention. And this concludes this very interesting presentation, and now let's go back to the original slide deck. In conclusion, we learned about the first steps of DFS in the SIGINT-enabled cyber operations, the MALLARD station and how it is jointly operated by the NSA and DFS, as well as clear evidence of the close collaboration of the two nation states in terms of intelligence sharing. All of that is part of the 21st century cyber espionage world, which remains in the shadows like it always has, but these days more and more in the shadows of cyberspace without many realizing it. But that's expected, since nothing is as it seems.